Last season, the Aussie Outback proved so bloody tough that 24 new hopefuls are doing it all again. But there's a catch.
It will be a game so intense that you will need the help of a loved one to help you through.
For the first time, players enter the game in pairs, and if they want the sole survivor crown, they'll have to beat their partner to get it.
Playing survivor with your spouse is a very dangerous idea.
You never know how it's going to play out.
This year, two-time American survivor champ Sandra Diaz-Twine is heading to the Outback along with her secret weapon. Y'all ready
for this? My baby girl Nina. Y'all better look out, because I taught her well.
And they're not going down without a fight.
If me and my daughter have to go head-to-head, I'm going to beat her down.
This game is on!
I love this. Sandra Diaz-Twine joins us now from North Carolina. Welcome. You made history as the first person to win American Survivor twice. That's got to give you confidence going into the Aussie Outback, yeah?
It definitely did, but that also gave me pause to remember, hey, they might know who you are, and if they do, they're going to want you out immediately. So it was more of a nervous kind of thing going into the game, and I was hoping that no one knew who I was, but that wasn't the case.
But also, winning American Survivor twice is one thing, but this is Australia. This is the big league now.
It is. Let me tell you, when I watched all the past seasons of Australian Survivor, I was definitely nervous. I was scared. I was anxious. I was like, oh my God, they rely and depend so much on a player's physical ability to win challenges for the tribe. And that's not who I am. So I actually started going to the gym because of it.
Sandra, this is the first time Australian Survivor has been played in pairs, which is massive. How does having a partner change the dynamic of what's always been an individual game?
I thought I wouldn't worry about my daughter, but I actually thought about her all the time. I told her from the beginning, I was like, baby, hopefully they won't know who you are. I didn't know we were going to both show up together. I was hoping we would be split. Nothing was ever said. I just gave her a list of different things I thought that she should do to help her game out. But she has her own mentality. She has her own way of playing Survivor. She's been watching the game since she was 5 years old. She never missed a season. So I knew she was up to the challenge. So I was just like, baby, whatever happens, you have to play your game. I can't focus on you and you can't focus on me.
Gosh, so you were willing to cut her loose if you had to?
You have to on Survivor because sometimes it's not even your choice. You definitely can't win the game by yourself and you have to have people willing to play with you. And I was hoping they'd at least want to play with her or even play with me.
Sorry, this sounds like a polite way of saying, yes, I was prepared to stab my daughter in the back.
I definitely told my daughter, baby, get ready because I will do whatever it takes to stay in the game as long as I can. Yes. And with my daughter the same, I'm sorry. It's like I gave you a roundabout answer when I just should have said, yes, I'll stab her in the back.
Thank you.
I will
much.
Stab anybody in the back for that prize money.
Sandra, in the American edition, you were in Panama. I think you were in Samoa as well. How did the Australian Outback compare to those two locations?
The Australian location and even the game period was the hardest Survivor I had ever done, especially at the age of 47. I'm not getting any younger. It's not easier to put one foot in front of the other when you're starving. A lot of people are like, oh, it's easy. No, it's not, especially not for me, but I hung in there.
Well, we cannot wait for it. Australian Survivor Blood versus Water kicks off tonight right after us, 7:30 right here on 10. Sandra, thank you so much. We can't wait to watch you in the Outback.
My pleasure. You guys take care and thank you for having me on. And I love Australia and I loved every single person that was out there that played with me.
Have fun. Can't wait for that.
Cannot wait.
Do you reckon you love them because you beat them? Should we be reading that as a song?
Well, she's very honest. I'll give her that.